destruction is at hand. Die, Outlander.
Protect the Harbinger!
Killing you will make an excellent story.
So I got some cool cards here. This one, the number on the top left is how much it costs to play the card. If you look at the bottom, the blue circle at the bottom right is how much magic I have per turn. And the card ability, you can see when he dies, he deals 3 damage to a random enemy. So he's got the number on the left of the sword is the amount he attacks with. The one on the right is how much health he has.
Now this is fun,
so it's all, every card has something different. Can you hear me? Do you hear me well? Diamonds up at the top here.
Now this is a fine piece of steel.
Every 5, you break one of the blue crystals, and when you break a blue crystal, they draw a card. Each of these cards typically has some bullshit attached to them. Like when this guy attacks, he deals 2 damage to your opponent. The opponent would be the face up here. As long as you break that number by their face, you win the game, no matter what creatures are on the board. And a prophecy means if they break one of those crystals, which they call runes, you can play that card instantly for free if you draw it when they break one of those crystals. I'm gonna push my luck. This one draws a card, and if it's a prophecy, you play it for free. Let's test my luck.
That was a mistake.
Yeah, it was a mistake. You better do something. Is that any better? Can you hear me over the volume now? Voice too low. I can't do anything about that. Stupid phone, you know. This dude's gonna kill me in one hit. Oh no. Ugh. I don't know if I can even do anything. If he hits me for that one damage, I'm done. Nah, he quit. He knew he was done for. And this game's not like Rivals, you know, you get so many options to choose from. All these cards, you know. And that's just, they got all these different colors with different cards. It's not bad. I think I was in the top 1,000 somehow last month. You can call me if you have to. I don't give a shit. Your number might pop up on the stream, though. I like that. I'll keep that. It's looking good.
Thank you.
I bring justice.
Let's do the fisting.
Can you hear me now? It's probably on my end too. So I know there's a lot of action going on here. You got any questions? No, I'm not really sure.
Forest, come on, let's...
Yeah, I'm on the Wi-Fi on the verge of the backyard.
By Akatosh, I will end you.
We must protect our stronghold.
Killer. If you have any questions, just ask and I'll explain what's going on here. I'm trying to let you read these cards a little bit. Catch what's going on. If you don't know the basics of it, every turn you get one magic, and that's the fractions you see in the blue circles. My AC turned on outside. It's not a new game, maybe for you, but as far as seeing it, but
this day is mine.
They're in my sight.
Nicely done.
Walk without
I need like some miracle play. Ugh. It's so fucked, man.
Your time has come.
Try some. You won't live to regret.
I'm sure I don't have any idea.
This one won't.
This is not going to do me any good.
I am ready to join the circle.
So this is a card to look out for. It's got a decent power. He's probably gonna kill it some way, somehow.
For Skyrim! For Skyrim!
Give me strength!
This one will!
So done. It's one hit kill for me.
Well fought. The coast is clear.
Uh-huh.
My bow is ready.
Horrible.
Ah.
Alright, we're gonna play something different. Steal and transform. Looking good. Okay, so I'm gonna try to explain this as we go. I only got one magic. He's got no magic. He didn't get a turn yet. I can't play shit because I ain't got any magic. At least not for these expensive cards. Now that's a bullshit card. Charge means it can attack the turn that it's played on. Pilfer means if he hits me in the face, which is this thing down here. If he hits me in the face, he shuffles one of these exact cards into his deck. To prevent that, we will shoot an arrow. Just deals one damage. Simple card. Deal one damage. If it survives, draw a card. It didn't. Next turn. I guess he didn't have anything to play. So what I do have, give a creature something. We're not going to worry about that because I don't have any creatures on the board. Steal an enemy creature with power 3. That would be the number on the left, his power. Number on the right is his health. So steal an enemy creature with power 3 or less until the end of the turn. It gains charge, so I'd be able to use it, but as soon as I give up my turn, it goes back to him. Breakthrough means if I hit a creature, but the rest of the power that after it kills them goes straight to the person's face. And on when I play the card, I can unsummon a creature in this lane. This one unsummons a creature with less power than him, so anything under 4, I can send it back into his hand. And this one unsummons any creature by 3. So the whole point of this deck is to either steal his creatures or throw him back in his hand. You can only hold 10 cards. If you lose, or if you get more than 10 cards, the card goes into your discard pile. And depending on the deck, you can't do anything with your discard pile. They do have decks that do work with a discard pile, and they're fucking brutal. So I'm kind of screwed at this moment. I can unsummon something, but unsummon what? I don't know. We'll just unsummon this thing for the hell of it. It's the most expensive card, I believe.
There are always the unsqualified Jokajit. My business is none of theirs.
So this horse is kind of cool. When he dies, he gets shuffled back in your deck. Did you just thumbs up me? What you got? What's your problem? What you complaining about?
Shall we put in a dishonest day's work?
You didn't like my horse? I'm doing pretty bad, man. I don't have anything to play here, really.
Maybe I got time for you.
Ah, fuck that card up.
I don't.
By our service, we honor kind.
So he shackled my card. Shackle creature can't attack next time. Shit.
You are dead! My business is none of theirs.
Shall we put in a dishonest day's work?
Now the fun begins, because I can actually play some of these cards. Oh, that sucked.
Shapeskin, fool! Face me, worthless skeever. My business is none.
But by that point, you're already dead, so then what? I'm probably dead here.
My business is none of theirs.
You can't escape.
Khajiit is having a good life.
It is what it is, man. It's however you look at it. I think Blizzard has a their version that's older than this. Sorry, I like this hand. I think I can rock that. My arrow shooter. Just a cheap, beefy dude with no health.
My arrows shall fly true.
Okay, so each of these lanes, this side of the lane, just a normal field lane, no special rules. But this side of the lane, the creatures get cover. So since they can't attack that first turn, they have that cloud that appears over them like this, meaning they can't be attacked by normal means. Like if he had somebody with cover, I'd just have to hit him here until the next turn. So if a creature has guard, they don't gain cover. They're always wide open, but you have to hit them before you can get hit in the face.
I'll cripple you.
Fire.
Oh yeah, so you got either three types of cards: creatures, actions, and supports. Supports are those little boxes you see here or here. And
by the first forge, as long as I draw breath.
Hold still.
And Oh yeah, so he's got that breakthrough. So whatever was left over from killing that creature, it hit me.
Apologies.
Ooh, that hurt. What do we got here? 4, 5. I can do 7.
By the first forge.
this dude does 2 damage to my opponent.
This day is mine.
And now we play the waiting game. Oh, that's game right there. That's a prophecy. He broke one of my crystals across my health bar. Every 5, you lose a crystal. And, this one just had, you know, he's got 4 health. He's gonna hate me.
Apologies.
It's the name of the game, though. Do it big. This is just cheap cards. Cheap cards that try to hit you in the face a lot. Mess with my scales.
I smell fresh meat.
So we'll play this guy first. I got a guard to back him up on the next turn if he played a creature. He did not. This guard will give him +2, but I'll play him over here to kind
of
split up the odds. You know, creatures in this lane can only attach creatures in that lane. The same for the other lane.
I'll cripple you.
And that is a support power. So when he summons it, he gains +1 magic, max magic, which stays with him. At the start of his turn, if he has that much magic, this card turns into that card. 8/8 creature in both lanes. So we want to get rid of that shit as soon as possible. I like this card because at the start of your turn, it just deals 4 damage. Always helps out. But we're trying to get him down quickly. It'd be quicker if I wasn't talking, but can't entertain that way. Oh, that hurts. Except for the card that matters. Let's really mix it up, man. Let's make that card hurt some. We still got that guard in case we gotta back it up. Now that's cards that kill creatures instantly and shit. Like that. Deals 4 damage.
I see that.
This just gives them an extra magic as long as it's on the board. It's my gamble card. Draw a card, and if it says prophecy, you can play it for free. I got like 30 something prophecy cards in this deck, so when it doesn't work, it's like shit. Out of 50 cards.
Nah,
that's the odds though, you know. Well, I'm glad it's working out.
I'll do what I can.
Rise, skinny.
Time to ride. Yeah!
So, he finally did some shit. So, you gotta keep in mind, he's got an extra magic as long as this is on the board. When he played this thing, If you have another creature in each lane, which I think he did, he gained plus one magic. So now he's at 9. He's got like 2 turns above me. And this thing, when it dies, he'll gain magic equal to his power, which is 1 right now. If he plays items on it and shit, it'll get kind of crazy. So I like to do immediate damage. This dude will throw 2 damage at him, plus the 3 I got on the board. That's 5. If I play this, that's 7. And I just have to hope I stay alive long enough where he doesn't get the ability to gain more health. Or I could play this random card, which I think I'm going to do. I think I'm in a big enough lead to just... It puts a random action, item, and a creature. Oh yeah, so there's 4 types of cards. Creatures, items, actions, and supports. So let's see how this goes. Alright. I'll just throw this out here.
You are no match for
hit him in the face. And I'll go. The timer was running out for my turn. So this creature has guard. This thing, an enemy creature, loses guard. So he thinks he's protecting him. If he doesn't destroy this, I'm gonna throw this on him for 3 magic, and I'll deal 2 damage, break his guard, and then hit him in the face for the win. Granted that he doesn't do anything to prevent that with his 10 magic this turn.
Come on.
I'll go ahead and be an asshole though and taunt him. Or if he kills that creature, that might slow me down too, my 3-2. He killed it. And gave me a card. That's a powerful card he played. If he hits me in the face, he gains 3 extra magic this turn. If he kills a creature with Slay, if he kills a creature, his Slay ability will give him 1 extra magic permanently. So, I think I'm going to transform that card into... Wait a second. This is a 1-1, and I can attack this turn. Plus the 2-2, that's a 3-3. That'll deal 2 more damage. And if I put this dagger on it, that's it. That's my play. I'll explain it. This dude can now attack this turn. Put this on him. Break that dude's shield. Give my dude some more magic. I mean, more power and more health, I mean. Hit him in the face. And my dude right here throw his knife for a win. That's what's up. Tough times. Midnight. That's all I got for tonight. See you later.